أهلا وسهلا بالجميع. محاضرة اليوم بعنوان Pulse Response and Rise Time. In this lecture, we will investigate the relationship that should exist between the pulse bandwidth and the channel bandwidth. As we know, the rectangular pulse contains significant high frequency components. When that pulse is passed through a band-limited channel, the channel will alter the shape of the input, resulting in linear distortion, amplitude, and phase distortion. فهي الشكل اللي عنا. This is the band-limited channel. We assume the channel bandwidth to be BCH. This is our input signal X of T in general with a Fourier transform X of F. And we assume that the bandwidth of X of T is some quantity B of X. So in general, we need to investigate the relationship that should exist between the signal bandwidth BX and the channel bandwidth BCH. In particular, the emphasis would be on the rectangular pulse. A rectangular pulse with duration T and with a Fourier transform G of F. طبعا احنا شايفين ال rectangular pulse. The rectangular pulse is a low pass signal with most of the energy concentrated between minus 1 over T and 1 over T. However, there are also significant amount of energy that falls outside the band 1 over T. This subject is of particular importance, especially when we study the transmission of data over band-limited channels. In the simplest form, a binary digit 1 may be represented by a pulse for T between 0 and TB, while binary digit 0 may be represented by a negative pulse, minus A for T between 0 and TB. Therefore, in order to retrieve the transmitted data, the channel bandwidth must be wide enough to accommodate the transmitted data. فهاي البلس يعني may represent digit 1 or may represent digit 0. So we will be transmitting digital data over a band-limited channel. And the objective is to try and retrieve the transmitted data with minimum probability of error. So in order to minimize the transmission error, the channel bandwidth BCH must be wide so it can accommodate a significant percentage of the input signal energy. To convey this idea in a simple form, we first consider the response of a first-order low-pass filter to a unit step function and then to a pulse. فراح نعالج المسألة على مرحلتين. المرحلة الأولى إن بدنا ناخد first-order channel and we will excite this channel by a unit step function. Then we consider the same problem but we excite it with the pulse G of T. فهي هدف المحاضرة. Step response of a first order system. Let X of T equal U of T be applied to a first order RC circuit. This first order filter is a fair representation of a low-pass communication channel. The system differential equation is X of T equal R times I plus G of T, which is the voltage across the capacitor. We know that for the capacitor, the current I is related to the voltage across the capacitor by C dV by dt or C dg by dt. This is the voltage across the capacitor, and so the current through the capacitor is C dg by dt, and the same current flows into the resistor. So the total input voltage equal the voltage across the capacitor plus the resistor plus the voltage across the capacitor. So it's Ri plus G of T equal R C dG by dt plus G of T, where G of T is the channel output. Now, let X of T be the unit step function U of T. The system differential equation becomes RC dG of T by dt plus G of T equal U of T. So the differential equation now is RC dG of T by dt plus G of T equal U of T. This is a first order differential equation, the solution of which is G of T equal 1 minus e to the minus t over RC U of T. The 3 dB bandwidth of this channel, which was derived in a previous example, is BCH equal 1 over 2 pi RC. طبعا الطريقة حتى نوجد الـ 3 dB bandwidth بناخد الترانسفير فونكشن للشانل، نوجد الماجنتيود وبنوجد القيمة، قيمة الفريكونسي اللي الترانسفير فونكشن بتنزل لواحد على جذر 2 من الماكسيموم فاليو. فهي وجدناها في مثال سابق، والشانل باندويث هو عبارة عن 1 over 2 pi RC. طبعا المهم في هاي العلاقة ان نعوض عن RC بدلالة للشانل باندويث. So the output G of T expressed in terms of BCH becomes G of T equal 1 minus e to the minus 2 pi BCH T U of T. This is the step response of the first order low pass filter or the first order low pass channel. We can define the difference between the input and the output as. This is the input, this is the step function, the input, and this is the channel output G of T. We define the difference U of T minus G of T. So the error equal U of T minus G of T equal e to the minus 2 pi B CH bandwidth of the channel T. So at any time, the error is expressed in terms of the channel bandwidth as e to the minus 2 pi B times T. Note that E of T decreases as BCH increases. As the channel bandwidth increases at a particular time, as the channel bandwidth increases, the error between the input and the output decreases. This means that as the channel bandwidth increases, the output becomes closer and the closer to the input. This means that this curve will be closer to the input. And ideally, when the channel bandwidth is infinite, then the error will be zero, meaning that the output instantaneously follows the input. In the ideal case, when the channel bandwidth becomes infinity, the output becomes a step function. In essence, to reproduce a step function or a rectangular pulse a channel with infinite bandwidth is needed. طبعا هاي اللي هي العلاقة النظرية اللي لازم تنوجد، لأنه إحنا بنعرف إنه الستيب فونكشن contains all frequencies from zero to infinity. فبالتالي حتى ندخل أو نقدر نعمل reproduction للستيب فونكشن لازم التشانل باندويث يكون infinity. فبالتالي طبعا هذا الحكي ما بيحصل إلا إذا كانت التشانل باندويث infinity، يعني بنقدر نعمل reproduction للستيب فونكشن. ف زي ما احنا شايفين الايرور is a function of two variables, time and the channel. احنا التركيز تبعنا مش على التايم، التركيز تبعنا على التشانل باندويث، انه كل ما كبر التشانل باندويث كل ما قل الايرور، يعني كل ما الاوتبوت اصبح اقرب للانبوت. وبالتالي لما يكون التشانل باندويث انفينيتي الاوتبوت ينطبق على الانبوت، يعني will follow the input exactly. من الاشياء الاخرى المهمه اللي بتتعلق بالسيستمز هي الرايز تايم. So the step response and rise time of a first order system. The rise time is a measure of the speed of rise of the output of a system due to step function applied at its input. One common measure is the 10 to 90% rise time, defined as the time it takes for the output to rise between 10% to 90% of the final steady state value when a step function is applied to the input at t equal to zero. So this is the input, this is the input, and this is the output. The rise time is the time it takes for the output to change between 10% and 90% of the steady state output value, or the steady state value, final value. Let T1 be the time at which the output reaches 10% of the final steady state value, and T2 be the time at which the output reaches 90% of the steady state value. The rise time is T2 minus T1. This is the time over which the output changes between 10% and 90% of the steady state value. For a first order system, one can use these equations. This is point one. Equal 1 minus e to the minus 2 pi b t1 when the output reaches 90%. We have 0.9, 1 minus e to the minus 2 pi b t2. We solve these two equations for t1 and t2, and the result is the rise time tr equal T2 minus T1 equal 0.35 divided by BCH. This is the channel bandwidth, which means that as the channel bandwidth increases, the rise time decreases. So there is an inverse relationship between the rise time and the channel bandwidth. As the channel bandwidth increases, we have another curve like this curve over which the output changes from 10% to 90% of the steady state value. But now this rise time is smaller than the original rise time. فTr T2 minus T1 equal 0.35 divided by B channel. From this result, we conclude that or increasing the bandwidth of the channel will decrease the rise time, implying a faster response. So as the channel bandwidth increases, the output will follow the input at a faster rate. الآن بعد ما وجدنا الستيب ريسبونس، الآن بنقدر نستفيد من العلاقات السابقة ونوجد البلس ريسبونس. So the pulse response of a first order system. It is the response of the circuit to a pulse of duration tau. So this is our pulse of duration tau that is applied to the system at t equal to zero. For the same RC circuit considered above, let us apply the pulse as the input x of t equal u of t minus u of t minus tau. So this is a representation of the pulse using the step function u of t minus u of t minus tau. Using the linearity and time invariance properties, the output due to the pulse can be obtained from the step response g of t as. So we have a step function applied at t equal to zero. The response due to the step function is the step response g of t. At some later time, we have another step function with negative amplitude applied at t equal tau. The output due to this pulse is g of t minus tau. So we have made use of the linearity and time invariance properties of linear systems, and the output is output y of t equals zero for t less than zero, and it rises exponentially زي ما شفنا في السلايد السابقة 1 minus e to the minus 2 pi b t for t between 0 to tau, and then decreases exponentially beyond t equal tau 1 minus e to the minus 2 pi b tau e to the minus 2 pi b t minus tau for t larger than tau. This response is sketched below. This is the output due to this step function, and then the output decays exponentially for t greater than tau. From the equation above, we observe that the output y of t approximates the input x of t, provided that y of tau is greater than 0.99. طبعا احنا اللي بنحكي فيه انه at steady state within this pulse the output at time t equal tau should be at least 99% of the steady state value. So in essence, the output, the channel output at t equal tau is very close to 1. And this condition is met using this equation when the bandwidth of the channel times the duration of the pulse is greater than 1, or the bandwidth of the channel is greater than 1 over tau, which is the duration of the pulse. فإذا توفرت هاي العلاقة عندنا الباندويث للتشانل ضرب البلس ديوريشن أكبر من واحد البي تايمز تاو التي إيكوال تاو بي تايمز تاو close to 1 we have 1 minus e to the minus 2 pi which is very very close to 1. طبعا اذا بدنا approximation اكثر بناخد العلاقه بتكون اكثر, بس هاي يعني العلاقه معقوله جدا انه بدنا الاوتبوت at time t equal tau إن نوصل ما بدنا خلال هاي الانترفال إنه الاوتبوت يلحق كيرف اللي ما يوصل للستيت ستيت فاليو, يعني قبل ما يوصل للقيمة النهائية تدخل عندنا الامبلس اليونت ستيب فانكشن الثانية ويبدأ ينزل بهذا الشكل. فإحنا معنيين إنه خلال الانترفال من زيرو لتاو إنه الاوتبوت يصير قريب جدا من الستيد ستيت فاليو 1. هذا الشرط اللي حطيناه اللي هو بي سي اتش ايكوال 1, واللي زي ما قلنا بنعوض عنه بي سي اتش في تاو ايكوال 1. الترم الثاني بيكون اي تو ذا ماينس 2 باي, هذا كتير صغير الترم وبالتالي الاوتبوت بيكون قريب جدا من الواحد. فاذا يعني في عندنا العلاقة الأساسية إنه الشانل باندويث لازم يكون على الأقل واحد على البلس ديوريشن حتى نقدر نحصل على شكل قريب من هذا الشكل. لازم الباندويث للشانل يكون على الأقل أكبر من واحد على البلس ديوريشن. هذا طبعا رح نشوفه على السلايد القادمة على الشكل التالي. هذا الشكل the figure below shows the Fourier transform of the input and the channel. This is the Fourier transform of the input. And this is the Fourier transform of the impulse response or the transfer function of the channel. To reproduce the input, the channel bandwidth should be wider than the message bandwidth. فبشكل عام بنقول the channel bandwidth should be wider than the message bandwidth. خلينا نشوف الـ ideal case. This is the ideal case where the input is applied to an ideal channel. The message bandwidth is BS, the channel bandwidth is B sub H. To reproduce the output in this ideal condition, we need B sub H to be greater than B sub S. When this input is applied through this channel, the input is multiplied by the transfer function of the channel, which is 1. So we multiply S of F by 1 within this duration, and the output is Y of F, which is an exact reproduction of the input. So this is the ideal representation of this statement. To reproduce the input, the channel bandwidth should be wider than the message bandwidth. طبعا احنا بنعتمد على العلاقة الأساسية للtransmission of signals through linear systems, Y of F equal Fourier transform of the input times the transfer function. When the transfer function is ideal equals 1, as in this example, Y of F is approximately equal to X of F. مثل هذا الوضع. ف إذن في عنا علاقة أساسية سواء في هذا المثال أو في غيره إنه the channel bandwidth should be larger than the message bandwidth. الآن بنيجي على ال practical case والإكزامبل تبعنا اللي قلنا فيه إنه لازم ال bandwidth للشانل to be greater than 1/1/tau. طبعا 1/tau is the bandwidth of the pulse or the null bandwidth of the pulse which we apply to the channel. 1/tau is the bandwidth of the pulse. This is the channel bandwidth B. So اللي بنحكيه انه هاي البلس بدها تمرق خلال هذا الفلتر وبالتالي حتى هاي البلس نقدر نشوف نسخة عنها على الاوتبوت لازم معظم الانرجي اللي فيها لازم معظم الانرجي اللي موجودة في هاي السيجنال تكون موجودة ضمن الباندويد للشانل فبالتالي هاي مثلا ممكن نعتبره هو ال 3 dB bandwidth للشانل ال 3 dB bandwidth للشانل فالمطلوب منا انه الباندويد للشانل هذا الباندويد للشانل يكون اكبر من الباندويد للبلس 1/tau هو النال باندويد للبلس ب هو ال 3 dB bandwidth للشانل وبالتالي حتى نقدر نعمل ريبرودكشن للبلس لازم هاي العلاقة تنطبق انه للشانل باندويدث للشانل باندويدث لازم يكون اكبر من البلس باندويدث ف if the channel bandwidth is much wider than the message bandwidth then we have الاوتبوت approximately equals the input زي ما موضح عنا بالايديال كيس والبراكتيكال كيس فلازم الان يكون موجود او العلاقة تكون موجودة انه الباندويث للشانل اكبر من 1/tau فبالنهاية we have this relationship to data transmission in digital communication systems data are transmitted at a rate of RB bits per second the time allocated for each bit is tau equal 1/RB to enable the receiver to recognize the transmitted bit within its allocated slot and to prevent crosstalk between neighboring time slots we require that the bandwidth of the channel to be greater than 1/tau and 1/tau is nothing but the data rate of our system. So we have this fundamental result. The channel bandwidth in binary digital communication should be larger than the rate of the data sent over the channel. فبنرجع مرة تانية للسلايد الأولى. This pulse may represent digit 1 or digit 0 and this pulse is transmitted over the channel. So in order for the system to recognize bits 1 and 0, the bandwidth of the channel, should at least be greater than the data rate. The data rate is 1/tau. Tau is the time allocated for binary digit 1 or binary digit 0. فهاي هي المحاضرة. فبالأساس يعني محور المحاضرة إن بنحاول نوجد علاقة ما بين الباندويث للشانل وما بين الباندويث للسيجنال اللي بدنا نعمل لها ترانسميشن على الشانل. المهم حتى نقدر نعمل ريبرودكشن للانبوت لازم الباندويث للشانل يكون كتير كبير بحيث انه يمرر اكبر كمية ممكنة من الانرجي اللي موجودة في السيجنال وبالتالي نقدر نقول إنه الأوتبوت واي أوف تي is a reproduction of x of t. هاي نهاية المحاضرة، إلى اللقاء.